One of the directives of the permaculture designer is to design with nature. And you can only design with nature if you understand how nature works. Imagine the level of understanding of water flow down this mountain that they needed in China in order to build these rice paddy terraces by hand over many generations. It is this level of nature awareness we seek when using permaculture. The next directive is to design for culture. This is Kibbutz Nahalal in Israel, and it was established in 1921. They have a tight residential and community center in the core of the community. Then it's ringed by industrial buildings, and then is ringed by agriculture. Imagine how it is to live in a village that is designed so intentionally for human movement and culture. It is this level of intention we use when designing human settlements using permaculture. Pattern observation feeds the creativity of the permaculture designer. Nature arranges itself in patterns that we can see replicated at other scales and in other situations. Look at how this tributary of the Amazon River is branched, just like a tree. And it's the same way that the veins in our body are branching. This is the pattern for how water and nutrients are distributed through matter, whether in a tree, a river system, or in our own vascular systems. Understanding these patterns is called pattern literacy. Observing the patterns of indigenous cultures is just like observing nature, because they lived in a place for generations upon generations without destroying it or importing energy sources from across the globe. This is a traditional village in the country of Yemen on the Arabian Peninsula. There is deep wisdom to the practices of many native peoples, and studying their agricultural and land management practices can provide lots of information about how to live in a sustainable way where we are.